What's going on everybody, this is Carter and I'm back with a pretty cool video that is too good to pass up. Today I'm spilling the beans of my top 5 go-to Maya simple hacks that I use every day. These nifty tricks have become a key part of my workflow, saving time and boosting my productivity. From forgotten UI options to simple but yet powerful tools, you are about to discover tips and tricks that no one is talking about. Whether you are a seasoned pro or just starting, these tricks will be helpful and beneficial for your CD work. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro!
Hi there, fellow 3D artists. Let's kick things off with a simple but awesome trick. We all know how frustrating file dialogues can be in Maya, right? Well, I've got a nifty trick up my sleeve to make your life way easier. Forget about that clunky default file dialog. Let me show how to switch the OS native file dialog, which is way more user-friendly and intuitive. Go to Windows, Settings and Preferences, and Preferences. Then under File Projects tab, scroll down to File Dialog tab. Switch to OS native and save. Trust me, once you make this simple change, you'll wonder why you didn't do it sooner. Say goodbye to file dialog frustration and embrace a smoother workflow in Maya. Next up, I've got something super cool to show you. Ever found yourself tediously combining and separating objects in Maya, one by one? It's a real time killer. But fear not, I've got the ultimate time saving solution. A custom script that lets you combine and separate objects with a single click. Yes, you heard me right, just one click. The script is available for free in the video description, so you can easily access and download it. Get ready to supercharge your workflow with it. Who's up for a little precision power up? You know how tricky it can be to get the perfect extrude or bevel in Maya, right? Sometimes it feels like trying to thread a needle. But here's the secret sauce. You can adjust the drag sensitivity. Say what? Oh yes. Let me show how it's easy to fine-tune that extrude and bevel drag speed. Let's create a cube for example. Select an edge and bevel it. Sometimes, depending on the scale of your object, the sensibility of the values are off. And you have to enter the value by hand. Just click on that small clock icon and change the blue slide to the minimum. It's much smoother and precise now. By clicking on it multiple times, you can change the drag speed of the sliders. This trick will totally level up your game. Get ready to be the master of precision. This one is pure gold. You know how it goes. You've created a ton of shader in Maya. But now you need to switch to Arnold. It's a bit of a headache, right? Well, fret no more. I've got an awesome trick that will make your life so much easier. Let me introduce you to the Arnold utility, your new best friend. With a few clicks, you can easily convert those shaders to Arnold shaders, saving you tons of time and hassle. Time to bid farewell to frustration and embrace this game-changing tool. So, you know how we all switch views in Maya, right? Clicking here, tapping there. But guess what? There is a hidden gem that's been hiding in plain sight. You ready? Check out that camera icon, right up there in the top left corner of your view. Give it a friendly right click and boom, magic happens. Just like that, you've unlocked the most effective and simple way to switch views in Maya. No more fussing around with menus or marking menus. This one-click wonder is your ticket to swift view changes. And that, my friends, is what separates the pros from the rookies. It's all about those sneaky shortcuts and hidden tricks that give you the edge in Maya. So, take this newfound knowledge and happy creating.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.